Hey everybody, welcome to Tutorial Tuesday. Today's tutorial is brought to you by Marlana or Marlana. I'm saying both names because I don't know if I'm saying it right. So yes, this is brought to you by her. This is one of her own patterns that she sent to me and asked me to do a tutorial on. So I thought, cool, I would love to do it. So yes, this is her pattern. And if you have any questions regarding this pattern, feel free to message me. I will try to put the pattern in the description box. And if it's not there, send me a private message and I'll send you the pattern. But it's very simple. So this is a beginner, I would say beginner patterns, very easy to do. And I'm going to be using cotton yarn, and you can use any worsted weight yarn that you choose. And I'll go over what else you need for this tutorial in the next clip. So if you're ready, get your hook and your yarn and let's get started. Welcome to Tutorial Tuesday. This tutorial, I will be doing a tutorial on a pattern that was sent to me by Marlana or Marlana. She requested that I do a tutorial of her pattern. So this will be her pattern. I will try to have the written instructions in the description box. And if you have any questions, just let me know. But remember, this is not my pattern. This is Marlana's pattern. And that is what I'm doing the tutorial on. And it's on a very small, I call it a coin purse, but she says that it's a pocket purse. So let's get ready with the tutorial. You'll need an eye hook, a tapestry needle, of course, your choice of yarn, worsted weight, and I'm using the Sugars and Cream twist. And then you will need a button. And so here's one of the buttons I got from Walmart. All right, and of course, you would need scissors. So if you're ready, let's get started. So you're gonna start off with your slip knot. So you're going to start off with your slip knot. Okay. So now you're going to chain 16. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So you're going to do a half double crochet into the second chain from the hook. There's one there and one there. Do a half double crochet in the second chain from the hook and in the remaining chains for a total of 15 half double crochets. It's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and the last one, 15. Okay, that was your round one, or row one. For row two, you're going to chain two, 1, 2, and for each remaining rows, you're going to chain two at the beginning of each row. Turn your work around, do a half double crochet into the second chain from the hook. So we got 1, 2, actually a third chain, my bad. Half double crochet. And in each remaining for another total of 15. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
10, 11, 12, 13, 14. And the last one, I hit it through both loops, 15, and I didn't, hold on. There we go. Last one, 15, chain two, turn your work around, you're ready for row three. So for row three to row eight, you're gonna repeat what you just did for row two, okay? So, which is half double crochet in each stitch for a total of 15, okay? So I will, this is row three, I'll meet you at the end of row eight. Okay, so I am at the end of row eight here, finishing up the last few half double crochets of the row, the last one. Okay, let me make sure this is row eight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes, it is. Okay, so you're at the end of row eight. You're now going to chain one, and you're going to work along the side here. Okay, so you're going to do one single crochet into the same, let's see, where can you say it? Right here in the first space. You can make a space if you don't have a space there. Okay, that's one single crochet. And you're going to do nine more across the side here evenly, okay? So we got 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and we'll do the last one right here, 10. So you want to do a total of 10 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, so now you're going to chain one, and that was row one of the side. So now we're going to work row two, and you're just going to repeat and do a single crochet in each stitch for a total of 10. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, and that is row two. So for row three, chain one, turn your work around. So row three and four, you're going to repeat what you just did for row two, and I'll meet you at the end of row four. Okay, so I'm at the end of row four, finishing up my last two single crochets. All right, so now you're going to chain two for row five. 1, 2. Turn your work around. You're going to do a half double crochet into the first stitch. And then a half double crochet in the next three stitches. Okay, so we have 1, 2, 3. So you should have did a total of 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now you're going to chain 2, 1, 2, and you're going to skip 2, 1, 2, and you're going to do a half double crochet in the last four stitches. One, two, three, and four. All right, you've just made a buttonhole. So you are complete with the crochet part of this. So now you're just going to chain one and have a very long tail to sew together your pouch. And then cut. And so this is the flap. We just did the flap part starting right here. So now what you do is you're going to fold this in half up to the flap. And you will sew your sides down, and you can either use, you know, the tail piece here if it's long enough, or you can weave this all the way down until you get to here and sew it, and then weave it through and then sew it up. You can do that. And you want to match where you want your button to button at, so you want it right about there. So I am going to be adding, and make sure your button can fit through here too. I am going to be adding my button on there. So, but I didn't stop there. Of course, that's not the end. What I did is I purchased some fabric to line this. I thought it would be a really cool idea to line it. So I'll show you my piece. Okay, so here's the piece I have here that I have got some fabric to line it, and it doesn't take much fabric. I bought one of those quarter squares for quilting that was on like 99 cents, and so I just lined it up to where the buttonhole is, so that row four and down here. And then I'm going to sew this on first by hand going up, and I'll try to record that part. And then I'm going to fold it in half and make sure I meet right where my flap folds over. Okay, like that. And then I'm going to slip stitch or whip stitch with the tapestry needle and thread and close this up. Okay, and I'm gonna attach my button. And then there's one more thing that I decided to do with this, and I'll show you in the next clip, or in a couple of clips from here, all right? So, if you don't wanna put a lining in it, as you see, I made more than one. If you don't wanna put a lining in it, you can just fold it in half, match it up to where that very first row is. You want to go to that very first row because it kind of bends over like that very easily. And you just want to sew your sides down, add your button, and you are complete. And weaving your ends, and you are complete with this purse pouch. I thought this was really, really cute. And her pattern is very, very accurate. So try it for yourself, and I think you'll like it. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and sew this on using white thread. So I'm just going to kind of whip stitch it. I'm just going to go a piece of the pouch so I'm just gonna just whip stitch it through like so. I kind of want the crochet edge to be out a little bit. I'm gonna go this way. So I'm just going to do this all the way around until it is on there securely. So I'm going to continue this going all the way around, and I'll be back when it's complete. Okay, so I am back where I started. So I'm back here at the beginning, so I'm just going to tie this off. I'm just around my needle a few times to kind of lock. Weave it through a little bit. I can take this pin out. Go back the other way. I want it to be like really secure. So it's pretty much secure. So I'm going to snip it. Set that to the side. Okay, so my lining is secure. Sorry for all the sniffing, you guys. I don't know. I hope I'm not coming down with a cold. So now I'm going to line this up. Make sure it matches where my row begins. I'm gonna do it right at that first row. So this will bend over like so. So I think what I'm gonna do now is attach my button. So my button looks like it should be about right there. So I'm gonna go ahead and attach my button at the mark. So I'm gonna go attach my button here, and I'll be right back. Okay, so I have my button on, which will be going like this. Perfect. Okay, so now what I want to do is sew my sides together. I'm going to do that now. Let me get my tapestry needle. Okay, so I got my tapestry needle. So I'm going to use... I was wondering if I should use this to sew in this. I could do that. I don't know. So I'll just start on this side. So I want to match it up. I'm going to button it up so I'll know for sure where I want it to be. Okay, so about there. Okay, so I'm going to match it up. Make sure it's the same on both sides. And I'm going to go in the inside of the back. Pull out long enough because you're going to go all the way to the other side. Okay, now I'm going to go back through it and go through the front, making sure you don't go through this part. You want that first piece. And then you're just going to whip stitch it around. To close it up. you're kind of just like going through the stitches basically. Coming to the bottom. Now, before I finish it off, I'm going to go through it like the cell to tie it tight. And now I'm going to weave it through the bottom. Just kind of weave it through. Try not to pull too tight. Weave it back through to the other end. All right, so now I'm going to do the same thing what I did on this side, but I'm working from the bottom going to the top. And I'll meet you when I'm done. Okay, so I finished it. And remember my end piece? Well, I'm going to cut. I'm going to tie these together first. I took my tapestry needle off. I'm going to tie these two in a knot. That's one. And one more, two. Then I'm going to even it up. And I'm going to cut my excess off. And then I'm going to weave it, both of these, through the pouch. First try? Yeah. Alright. So now I'm just going to weave both of these like back down the side I just worked up. And pull it through. If I can get it through. I probably put it through too many. Yeah, I probably did. But I'm going to work it. There we go. Alright, weave it through a little bit more, pull it through, and I can snip off the excess. Alright, so now I just want to cut this off, make the tail long enough. That's where we first started to close our sides. And I'm going to weave this through, going back down. And I'm also going to weave in this part here. And I'm going to weave it in through this way. I'm going to go this way. That way we can kind of reinforce this little piece right here. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and do that, and I'll be back. All right, so you are now complete with your pocket purse. So thank you so much, Marlana. And so here we are. I reinforced by weaving my excess yarn through here. I reinforced this little piece here because over time that may stretch out. So, and by lining it, it is lined. How did that, you can see a piece of the yarn there, but good. Doesn't matter. So you can put your ID in here or maybe money and put it in your purse pouch. And there you have it. So hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Very, very easy to make. This is a beginner pocket purse, I would say. So, and the options are, there's a couple of more options you can do. And I will tell you about them in the next clip. So thanks for watching, and until the next Tutorial Tuesday, God bless. Hey you guys, OVW here. Welcome back from the tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. Very easy and simple pocket purse. Really, really cute. It's already lined. You have the cute little button. You can use whatever style button. Just make sure that it can fit through the hole. I think this is so cute. But you know what? I didn't stop there.
I went ahead and I gave you another option you could do, and let me show you. I did one with Velcro. So as you can see, Velcro is lined on both sides. That way, if you have change in here or money in here, you know that it won't, you know, come out. It's very secure. And also I added a little link so it can go on your keys or your purse or wherever else you want to link it to. And it has the button and everything. So I figure I would use this for my money, like change, and like clip it on my keys or put my ID in it. Where is my keys? So I have my keys here. You could clip it on your keys. So you could just, I forgot what these rings are called, but you could just snap it on there. Or you could just clip it on there and have a little key, coin purse for your keys. And this is cotton, so you could just toss it in a wash whenever you need to. Another idea I had, and I got these rings from Michael's. I went to Michael's yesterday, and no, I did not buy yarn. Neither did I go down the yarn aisle, but I did good. I'm very proud of myself. I did good. Okay, so another idea I had was I got these. And these are like lobster claws, I guess. And I can also, instead of using this, or actually I probably could tack it on to that. Let's see. I probably could just add it on to that. Yeah. So I could just add it on to there. And then my purse here, oops. I could just snap it on. If I can get it on there. The bars are too big. But anyway, I'll try right here. Snap. Okay. I could just. Anyway, you get the idea. I think these bars are too thick, but you could just snap it on to your purse. So you can have a little coin purse on the outside of your purse. Or you can use this instead and clip it onto your keys. There we go. So I thought that was a really cute idea. And this is a really cute pouch. You can also make it bigger by going more than 8 rows, which means you would have to go more than 10 going across the top for the flap. So you could do a smaller size or bigger size. I really, really like this pattern, and I will make more. So thank you, Marlana or Marlana, for giving me this pattern to do a tutorial on. I hope you liked the tutorial. I hope I did your pattern justice. And I just had to add my own little, you know, the lining and everything. And so you can use Velcro or you can use a button closure, which I still use the button closure just to put the flap down. I also am doing another one. Here's, it's just pinned with the lining because I'm going to do a zipper. Yes, I'm going to put a zipper on here. So I'm going to do quite a few of these. And I use sugars and cream, like I said. And I have 1, 2, 3 done. Well, 2 done and 1 halfway done. And I still have more to do, maybe 1 more, maybe 1 more. So you can get about 4 of these little pocket purses out of 1 ball of sugars and cream. So definitely something to think about. So I only have 2 here, and that is the buttoned one with the lining, and then the keychain one with Velcro. So I really like this, and so I'm working on one for the zipper. I really like this pattern. I'm going to be putting this one on my keys, and since it's Velcro, I can put money in it. I'm not quite sure if it'll hold a credit card or not, but you can always try it out and see. So yeah, that is my tutorial of the day. Really, really cute. I'm going to do them in all different colors. So once again, Marlana, I say them both because I don't know which one is right. Thank you so much for sending me your pattern, and I enjoy making these, and I'm going to be making more in the future. Hope you all had fun following the tutorial, and down below I will put the pattern down below. And like I said, this tutorial was brought to you by Marlana, or Marlana, one of my friends, and I also a subscriber here on YouTube. So thank you so much. And once again, I hope you enjoyed it. Thumbs up for the super easy tutorial. And if you have any questions, feel free to post them down below or send me a private message. And yeah, you're probably going to see me one more time today. All right. So love you guys. God bless. Remember to keep God first in your life and everything else secondary. Bye. One thing I wanted to put out there, if any of you out there have your own personal pattern that you have created, but yet you don't know how to go about doing tutorials, well, I would love to be able to do a tutorial for you. So if you would like for me to do a tutorial on one of your own patterns, send me a private message and we can discuss everything. All right. So I just wanted to put that out there because not everybody have the ability to do actual tutorials. So since I do them and I love doing them, if you want me to do a tutorial on one of your patterns, and I'll also, of course, give you the credit of the pattern, I'm just doing the tutorial of it. There will be a link to go to get your pattern if your pattern is for sale or if it's on a blog or whatever. Feel free to send me a private message. So I just wanted to put that out there for those of you out there who are probably wanting to get a tutorial out on their pattern, but don't know how to go about it. All right.